And good evening. It's a Saturday night, November 14th. This will be a day that many of us remember because this is the day that the Lord chose to take his servant, Jay Adams, to be with him, to be home with him. So Jay's earthly time is done in terms of him living here. But I think it's safe to say there are few people that will continue to live on in the things that they've written and the insights that they've delivered and just the strength of their character. The thumbnail tonight is a vertical picture. Does it fit with the thumbnail? But it fits Jay because there he is with the shovel of the groundbreaking at Harrison Bridge Road Church. And that picture of him with that shovel is a man who's going to work, and it's been one of my favorite pictures of his. And I like to go through just some of his books because that have touched me. When I first met him in Ruth, and I met him in October of 1989. We've been reading him for years before that. But the first time we actually met him, first time I met him, Ruth met him in seminary. And he said, well, if you've read my books, you pretty much know me. And over the years, I would have to agree with that. So I'm just going to go through a few books here tonight, and podcasts, the videos. That'd be a little bit longer than normal, but it's certainly fitting for Jay. This first book I want to talk to you about is called The Use of the Scriptures in Counseling. And this is from actually 1976. We've held it together with outside covering title. It's kind of, you see it sort of falling apart, but just invaluable truth here. I've always thought that he should title the books maybe The Use of the Scriptures in Living instead of The Use of the Scriptures in Counseling is what this says, because it really does fit for life. I'm not going to read from any of the others, but just this one remains these 44 years afterwards, still remains super impactful to me. Here's one phrase from it. The Spirit leads not only out of, but also into. By his power, the believer can learn to resist the desire of the flesh and put to death the deeds of the body, and in its place to produce the fruit of the Spirit. He reprograms him for righteousness. To the extent that this fruit is present, the flesh cannot prevail, for it has been preempted by new patterns. And this is the way of the Spirit. And this is a book that is, those words resonated deeply. Even though I knew and was appreciative of counsel and other books, this one was one of the first ones to really drive home truths. Another book, Meaning and Mode of Baptism, just with great clarity laid out what I believe is the biblical practice of baptism. And this, again, short book, tiny book, but characterizes so much of Jay's work. It's biblically clear. He gets right to the scripture, and that's what he cares about. You know, if you struggle with issues about evil in this world, the grand demonstration, again, clear exegetical work about how to look and how to see the problem of evil in this world, how it fits into God's great plan that he does for us. If you have questions about guidance, again, short, concise book on guidance. Just phenomenal. And again, the focus of everyday life is what's here. And that book, again, came along at a really critical time. Makes sense. Thirst for Wholeness, about how to be whole in life. Some studies in the book of James. It's really, really helpful to do that. One of his books that's probably impacted me, and certainly the counseling that I've done, and perhaps more than any other, is this book. World's Worst Cover, but just beautiful context. Insight and Creativity in Counseling. We've got to have insight. We've got to be creative as we counsel. And that's what Jay was all about. Just enormous insight, enormous creativity. language of counseling. And again, language of living, language of Christianity, about how language is an attribute of God, a communicable attribute of God, and has a particular role for us. And it's, language is important, because that's what God chose. He chose to reveal us in his ways in the purpose and place of language. Forgiveness, really confusing to a lot of folks. This book, Forgiven to Forgiving, lays out biblical principles of what forgiveness is all about. And the, oops, dropped some books there, but it's okay. Self-esteem movement swept through the Christian world in the 70s and 80s. Well, Jay was right there on top of it, giving us a biblical view of self-esteem, self-love, self-image. Who am I? Why am I here? Where am I going? Like so many of his books, they really fit the category of unique and was shaping to me, certainly. One that has impacted me and Ruth in ways more than I can say is this one, Back to the Blackboard. If you want to understand what's going on in education today, you need to read this book. It's just a, again, biblical exegesis into the problems of life, and in particular, how to think about Christian education. A book that just came out when we met Jay back in 1989 was A Call for Discernment. And as Christians, we need to be discerning. Well, here it is. Jay lays it out for us. Again, coming at a critical time in my life and Ruth's life, and helpful to us. The End Times, Jay's first book that he ever wrote before any of the counseling stuff, was this one, Times at Hand. Followed years later by this book, Signs and Wonders in the Last Days. To my mind, great clarity about all the stuff with eschatology and end times. Jay's understanding was his love of scripture is massive. And that's what drives him. And that's what made him so special. This book, not many people know about it, just the use of the rod and staff and counseling and neglected aspect of shepherding about how elders need to be go about their job. I like it because it's a book that Jay actually dedicated to me. It says, dedicated to Elder Jay Yance, who bugged me into writing this book. That's pretty typical of Jay, but again, so valuable for us. So much of the Christian life is about having a balanced view. Well, maintaining the delicate balance in the Christian life is huge. This one, again, not many people know about it, but it's a gem. Christian Living in the World, about how the world impacts us as Christians. Vitally important book. I always gave Jay a hard time. I said, you know, you need to write a book about Christian living in the church. He's not ready for that one yet. But anyway, it's a really, really cool book. Another book is huge, Winning the War Within. Jay thought this was one of his most important books. And it gives us an understanding of the battle with the flesh that we have. And again, it's hugely significant. And then, a man who was really serious about what he did. This is part of the Christian Counselor's commentary. So he wrote a specialized commentary on the entire New Testament about how the Bible impacts Christian counseling, how we can use it, gave us the tools that we need. Jay was a Greek scholar, so he has his own translation, been blessed to have this. This is his translation of the New Testament and the Proverbs. Invaluable from that, but it shows the depth of his love for God and love for God's word. So we've talked about counseling, we've talked about language and linguistics, we've talked about discernment, we've talked about end times, we've talked about this battle that we have with the flesh, and how we can be discerning Christians. But Jay covered all those things and more. I've just given you a short little excerpt of some of the books that have impacted me. But I can't think of any better way to remember him this night than to consider his books. I would commend them to you. Again, longer visual video than normal, but Jay Adams is a special man. He's in heaven now, and the earthly journey is over. But his life goes on, his words go on, and the God that he wrote about goes on, because it was the God he loved. And it's the best thing you and I can do is to pursue that God. So, thankful for Jay. I'm thankful for God for giving us this incredible gift of this man. Rest well this night. And thanks for going through this with me. And Lord willing, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.